This video is going to be about interpreting slopes, intercepts, and points in word problems. So let's look at some word problems and try to understand what this means. Okay, so here's this word problem. An electrician charges $80 for a house call plus an additional $50 for each hour of work. Then there's the first question. Write an equation for the cost, C, of hiring the electrician in terms of the hours, H, that the electrician works. Okay, let's see what we can do with that. So when it says write an equation for something, the thing we're writing it for the cost, is what we're going to start with. In other words, the cost equals. And then when it says in terms of, that's going to be our independent variable, and it's probably going to be on the right side of the equation. So let's see what the right side of the equation should be. Okay, so what does it cost for this guy to work for you? Well, it says he charges you $50 for each hour of work. So if you worked for 1 hour, it would be 50 times 1. If you worked for 2 hours, it would be 50 times 2. 3 hours would be 50 times 3. So if he works for H hours, then it would mean it would be 50 times H. So we're just going to take $50 times the number of hours that he works, and we'll find out what he's charging. But he also charges you just to show up at the house. He charges you $80 for the house call, and then he starts to work. So in addition to this $50 for each hour, he's also charging you $80. Okay, so the equation is a nice linear equation. C equals 50H plus 80. Let's look at the next part. It says, interpret the meaning of the slope in the context of the problem. Let's look at a graph of this. Just make a rough graph. So if we had a graph, we could take the C as the vertical axis. That would be our dependent variable. And the H, which is the number of hours, that'd be the horizontal axis, our independent variable. And we would have some tick marks here to show the hours and some tick marks to show the cost. We'll fill some numbers in, I guess, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And we know we're starting at, let's say this is 80 right here. We're starting at 80 and we're going up. We know that from the equation, that the vertical intercept right here is going to be 80 and the slope is 50. It says interpret the meaning of the slope in the context of the problem. Well, the slope is 50, but the meaning has to do with the word problem itself. And what that 50 means is that for each hour of work, he charges $50. The rate of increase at which he's getting his money is $50 per hour. And actually, it tells you that right in the problem. You don't have to do an equation for it. It says he charges an additional $50 for each hour of work. Okay, so the slope, in terms of the meaning of a slope, is usually going to be the rate at which something happens. Okay, let's see what C says. Interpret the meaning of the vertical intercept. Okay, well, the vertical intercept, we can do that right from the equation. That's 80, since this is an equation in slope-intercept form. The intercept is the 80. So we know what the vertical intercept is, but what does it mean? Well, this vertical intercept happens, like all vertical intercepts, when the dependent variable is 0. So all that's telling you is that when no time has elapsed, before he has started to work, the charge is $80. And we also have that right in the original question. He charges $80 for a house call. He hasn't started to work yet. He's already charging you $80. So that's the meaning of the vertical intercept. There's one more question here. Interpret the meaning of the ordered pair 2.5, 205. So if we had to do that on the graph, 2.5 would probably be, I guess between 2 and 3, we're going to have 2.5. And then 205 would be here. Well, 2.5 is an H value. It's time. And 205 is a money value. It's the charge that he's giving you. Remember, the independent variable comes first, 2.5, then the dependent variable. So what this ordered pair is telling you is that when he has worked 2.5 hours, the charge is going to be $205. Okay? Pause this and think about all this if you need to. Go over again if you need to. Okay? But I'm going to go on and try to do another problem before we run out of time. Okay, here's one more problem. Mr. Lucky goes to a casino with $350 in his pocket. He plays the slot machines and loses steadily at the rate of $50 per hour. I guess that should be a lesson about trying to get rich at a casino. Write an equation to show how much money, M, Mr. Lucky has in terms of the amount of time that he has spent at the casino. Okay, so we're writing an equation for M. What that means is we're going to start out with M equals. Now, what do we know? In terms of time, every hour that passes, he loses $50. So if he gambles for 1 hour, if he plays the slots for 1 hour, he's got $50 times one less than he began with. If he plays for 2 hours, he's got $50 times two less than he began with. The $50 is really a negative amount. The amount of money he has is decreasing. So we're going to want a negative 50 here. And if we don't know how much time he's spent at the slots, we don't know how many hours, we'll use the variable, the independent variable t. Okay? Let me make these numbers a little nicer. Okay. Now, we also know that he started out with some money. In other words, before he started gambling, he had $350. That's what we're subtracting this $50 per hour from. So he has $350 to start with. If we think about this equation is now in slope-intercept form, where I have m equals negative 50t plus 350. If I think about rearranging the right side of the equation, I could say, oh, there's $350 minus 50t, or minus $50 for each hour that he works, that he gambles. Okay, so there's the equation. Now, it says, interpret the meaning of the slope in the context of the problem. Okay, so let's just do a graph once again. This graph's going to go downhill because he has less and less money as time goes on. Time, t, is the independent variable, and m, for the amount of money he has, is the dependent variable. And the meaning of this, the slope is negative 50, but the meaning is that every hour he has $50 less, which is what the original problem told us. He's losing steadily at the rate of $50 per hour. The slope is a rate. It's a rate of change. Interpret the meaning of the vertical intercept. Okay, so that vertical intercept is going to be over here when time is zero, and this point over here is 350. Well, all that means is that's how much money he started with. The vertical intercept is how much money you start with when the dependent variable is zero. Interpret the meaning of the horizontal intercept. Okay, so that horizontal intercept is going to be somewhere over here. This is going to be some number of hours. I don't know how many hours it's going to be. And the M variable, the dependent variable, is going to be zero. What that's saying is, when we get down to here on the graph, at the horizontal intercept, he's run out of money. That's what the horizontal intercept does. It's when your dependent variable is zero. Interpret the meaning of, the horizontal intercept. Interpret the meaning of the ordered pair 4, 150. Okay, so let's see. I guess 4 would be someplace like around here, and 150 would be like this. And what that's saying is, remember, the first part is the independent variable. So 4 is time, or hours, and 150, the second part of this ordered pair, is the dependent variable, or the amount of money he has. So this is saying, when he's been playing the slots for 4 hours, he has $150 left. Okay? I'm going to do one more of these in another video. So hang around, and I'll see you soon.